Boo-Boo's army is... soon have the training center.
Yeah. This area as my own.
Come on.
hereby claim this area as my own. Yeah.
Capturing that base will weaken the enemy greatly. All units march!
I hereby claim this area as my own.
Come again!
Yeah.
I hereby claim this area as my own. Hereby claim this area as my own. Hereby claim this area as my own. I claim this area as my own. This area as my own. Hereby claim this area as my own. Hereby claim this area as my own. claim this area as my own. I hereby claim this area as my own.
Capturing the enemy's bases is the key to defeating them.
So you are the tacticians brought to me by Shun Yu and Guo Jia.
My name is Man Chong. My specialty lies in designing traps for castles and general defensive preparations. I am honored to make your acquaintance.
My name is Shun Yo. I am an expert in battlefield tactics.
I see. My army currently has nobody like either of you within its ranks.
Master Cao Cao. You have many mighty warriors, such as Master Dian Wei, beneath you. However, in order to eventually quell the chaos, you need skilled tacticians that can guide those warriors.
Master Guo Jia, Master Man Chong, Master Shun Yo, and myself, each of us has our own field of expertise. Together, we can help guide you on your path forward.
Excellent. I look forward to seeing just how far your talent can take me. My army is still rather small, but it has many talented warriors and strategists. I think our capability is sufficient for the task at hand. Our first move is to slay Tao Qian and obtain his lands within Shu Province. I would like to hear your opinion on the situation.
My lord, please forgive my impudence, but do you wish to attack Tao Qian in the name of vengeance?
If that is what the world thinks, then so be it. However, the point in attacking Tao Qian is to get at the man behind him, Yuan Shu.
Master Cao Cao is old friends with Master Yuan Shao. Similarly, Tao Qian is close to Yuan Shu, who is also at odds with Yuan Shao. I see where this is going.
I know that we cannot make our move while our army lacks in size. However, if we do not seize this chance to take Shu Province now, my journey becomes that much harder.
Your journey?
I seek to bring an end to the chaos and instill a new sense of order in the land. In order to do so, I must overcome the chaos through sheer military might.
A new sense of order. So, attacking Shu Province is the first step in making that a reality. I understand what you mean now.
Of course he must deal with the coward Tao Qian. You can make your move and cause him to think you wish to talk. At the same time, you place an army behind him. That actually makes things quite simple. We attack where their defenses are the weakest. Haha, Tao Qian won't know what hit him.
I see. With that supposition in mind, let us speak of tactics. Shunyo, what are your thoughts on the matter?
First, I think we need to dispatch an army to put down the resistance within Qing province.
You mean the former members of the Yellow Turbans that are terrorizing the area? How does that relate to our attack on Shu Province?
If you make a move, Tao Qian will think it is for revenge. If he truly is the coward Master Manchong suggests he is, he will hope to parley with you. Once he approaches the front lines, that is your chance to slay him. Even if you fail, it will slow him down, enabling an auxiliary unit to strike his flank.
Interesting. I like it. We shall proceed with your proposal. Many lives are likely to be lost on this path. However, it is a pain we must endure to end the chaos. Everybody, I ask that you join me in search of the greater good. Let's go. We shall slay Tao Qian and bring Shu Province under our control.
Cao Cao's gaze is turned outward. He does not appear to notice what is happening within his own ranks.
Then now is my chance! The name Cheng Gong will soon be known across the land!
We will slay Tao Qian and seize control of Shu Province. I will need your talents to make it a reality, though.
You have to be kidding.
I hereby claim this area as my own. I hereby claim this area as my own. I hereby claim this area as my own.
For my strategy.
Sing!
Advancing!
I hereby claim this area as my own!
Halt! The enemy is on its way here! Take defensive positions!
Our target has been determined. Capturing that area will def...
I wanted to avoid conflict if possible, but it seems I will have to be prepared to go to battle after all. This man is driven by hatred, and wages war to satisfy his desire for vengeance. I cannot let him take control of Shu Province.
Claim this area as my own.
You are a true warrior of the Three Kingdoms. No doubt about it.
Great as always! There was no need for my strategy!
Our target has been determined.
Yeah.
Capturing that area will deflate their morale.
Yeah.
Quite a spectacle. Truly amazing. Our target has been determined. Capturing that area will deflate their morale.
Great as always! There was no need for my strategy!
Yeah.
Our target has been determined. Capturing that area will deflate their morale.
You! Yay!
You've brought ruin to Shun, Zanza. Simply for the sake of your own personal vendetta. How could I lose to such a man?
I am willing to be reviled. If that is the price I must pay to continue on my path.
Liu Bei gave us a bit of trouble, but we've managed to mostly pare down Tao Qian's forces.
The enemy moved just as Master Man Chong and Master Shun Yeo anticipated. It sure helps to have quality strategists on your side.
Yes. Our forces have become more powerful than I imagined possible. It is only a matter of time before Shu Province falls to our onslaught.
My lord! It's Lu Bu! Yan Province is under attack by Lu Bu's forces.
Curse that Lu Bu. He could not have picked a worse time to invade.
In response to Lu Bu's attack, castles throughout Yan Province are defecting to his side. Upon hearing the news, Lord Shahu Dun and Lord Shun Wu have already set out for Yan Province.
Defecting? You mean the castle lords have turned their back on Master Cao Cao?
So, Lu Bu was the source of my premonition. I wonder if my uncle is okay.
I never expected Lu Bu to invade Yan Province at a time like this. Although, he is usually one to rely on brute force, not such refined strategy.
They defected due to Lu Bu's presence? I could understand them surrendering, but to immediately switch sides like that, there's something strange going on here.
It appears somebody has moved against us. Shu Province was just within our grasp. Now we have no choice but to deal with this situation first. Everybody, we must quickly return to Shuchang. I want Lu Bu driven from Yan Province immediately.
Things aren't looking too good, my lord.
If I am to realize a new ideal for the land, this type of thing can't be avoided. In fact, things are only likely to get more difficult from here on out. Although, I am quite impressed with your strength, Dian Wei. In fact, you remind me of Eli, the fabled hero of old.
There's no need for such praise. I simply do what I can to protect you from harm. You're an important person in this world, so I've got to give my best to help support your rise.
I appreciate your service. Having you at my side enables me to traverse the path I have set for myself, free from fear.
But because I'm at your side. You're embarrassing me. Of course, I'd feel better if you stayed behind me where it's safe.
My war is one to bring an end to the chaos that plagues this world. As such, I cannot simply cower behind my men. I must take the lead and set an example for all. Together, we'll create a new world where all may prosper. I'm depending on you, my very own Eli, to help me make it happen.
When you put it like that, I guess I've got no choice but to agree.
claim this area as my own.
I bring news. Ning Tao has fallen, and Master Li Qian has been slain. Most of the castles throughout Yan province have fallen to Lu Bu's forces.
Uncle, I promise that I shall avenge your death!
That leaves only Sha Ho Dun and Shun U in Juwen Castle. We must send them reinforcements right away.
No, Master Cao Cao. Juwen Castle will be able to hold out for a little while as long as those two are defending it.
Shunyo, do you concur?
Yes, I agree with Master Guojia. I think our first move should be to take back Ding Tao.
It's settled then. We will head to Ding Tao. Once it has been reclaimed, we will send aid to Sha Ho Dun at Juwen Castle, and then confront Lu Bu at Puyang. Let's go! This is the moment when we take back Yan Province from Lu Bu and his men.
Now is the time to attack. Everybody, to battle!
I hereby claim this area as my own. I hereby claim this area as my own.
Conquer this land. Capable of unifying this land.
I hereby claim this area as my own.
Too good for the enemy. It'll be put to much better use by us.
Men of Cao Cao's army, I'm afraid this castle now belongs to Master Lu Bu. Please make your exit in a swift and efficient manner. Thank you.
Sick of you shameless traitors! This place belongs to my lord! Leave at once!
Yeah.
to the enemy. It'll be put to much better use by us.
Impressive, cousin. You truly are the one that will conquer this land.
That area is too good for the enemy. It will be put to much better use by us. So.
Oh, I get it. That's where we're supposed to attack. Capture of that area is our goal. Secure it, and we will take the enemy's spirit as well.
Shang!
Yeah.
Cousin, you are a true warrior of the Three Kingdoms.
Yeah.
Let's go. Now is the time to attack.
Capture one of those unsightly positions. Follow me.
Yeah.
They've made it a fair way inside. It looks like I must think of something quickly.
Yeah.
I have no need of strategy. All I need to do is crush these maggots beneath my heels. Yeah. Yeah. So, J.K. Yeah. I tire of you.
I get worked up just watching you.
Yay!
See!
Successfully reclaimed Yan Province from Lu Bu. It is all thanks to you, Xia Houdun, and Xun Yu.
We are not worthy of your praise. Lu Bu was our main target, and we failed to capture him.
No, Master Xia Houdun. Given the circumstances, Lu Bu himself was not the most important thing. The problem was all of the castles across Yan Province that defected to Lu Bu's side.
Master Cao Cao displayed his strength in Shu Province. However, it was not enough to convince the people to follow him. Do you agree, Master Xun Yu?
Yes. The people do not put their faith in power, but justice and righteousness. Much like the campaign against the Yellow Turbans who opposed the Han, or the coalition to combat Dong Zhuo, who disrespected the Emperor and terrorized the people.
I see. So displaying our sense of righteousness along with our strength can go a long way in gaining the understanding and support of the people.
My lord, I bring news. Emperor Xian has escaped from Li Jue and Guo Xi and is requesting assistance at Luoyang.
Ha ha! What excellent timing.
My lord, we should assist the Emperor and take him under our protection. Nothing could be more righteous than that.
Although, if we are to aid the Emperor, we must do so quickly. I am certain that the other warlords are thinking the exact same thing.
Yes, I agree. As soon as our preparations are complete, we shall head to Luoyang.
Hey, Shunyo, you're pretty quiet for being a strategist. I thought you guys simply gave our lord good ideas without having to be prodded.
Easy now, Master Dian Wei. Master Shunyo has his reasons. He once proposed a plot to his friends and was ultimately imprisoned for it. So he prefers to practice caution. No inadvertent words or ideas. In fact, his careful nature is perhaps his best attribute.
Yeah, but there's no need for caution here. It's not like any of us are gonna turn against him.
We were just betrayed by Master Chen Gong. It is wise to learn from our brushes with misfortune.
I see. I guess you're right. Although, it all makes me kinda sad.
This area as my own. I hereby claim this area as my own. Yeah. I claim this area as my own. hereby claim this area as my own. Hereby claim this area as my own. Hereby claim this area as my own.
Thank you. Ah, Master Cao Cao. It is good to see you. Come, His Imperial Highness awaits you.
It seems Dong Zhuo caused even more destruction here in Luoyan than previously imagined. There are many problems with leaving the Imperial Court in Luoyang, the least of which is its inadequate defenses. The Emperor would be much safer in Xuchang.
Xuchang. His Imperial Highness has many strong connections to Luoyang, but I suppose sacrifices must be made for the greater good. Let us go greet him.
My lord! An army led by Li Jue and Guo Xi has been spotted west of Luoyang. It appears a number of their troops are already inside the city.
What? Curse those wretched traitors. They must be planning to abduct the Emperor.
Master Dong Chen, time is of the essence. We must see to it that the Emperor flees Luoyang at once.
Cao Cao, Yuan Shao's army has taken a position at Pulau Gate. He has placed Yan Liang and Wen Chao in the vanguard and seems to be welcoming our challenge.
He must have known we were planning to place the Emperor under our protection and decided to overcome us with brute force. A fairly impressive move for Yuan Shao. If we can break through Li Jue's forces to the west of Luoyang, we can make our way to Xuchang. Manchang, what's it look like to the south?
In the south, there is Master Yang Feng, formerly of the White Wave Bandits. If I recall correctly, he served Li Ju, but now appears to be protecting the Emperor. I have not heard good things about Master Yang Feng. However, I do have an old friend within his army. I believe we could turn to him for assistance.
A friend of yours, you say? What is his name?
His name is Master Xu Huang. He is a rather strange individual who is obsessed with his training, but I assure you that he can be trusted.
Very well. Manchang, let us call upon your friend. At present, we have Li Jue behind us, and Yuan Shao before us. It is likely there are more enemies to come. However, we cannot let them kidnap the Emperor. Everybody, let's go! We must safely escort His Imperial Highness to Xuchang.
Yes!
Your Highness, I am Cao Cao. I have come to escort you to safety. There are certain to be many threats along the way. First, I must take you to a safe location within Luoyang.
Oh, you have come for me. I place myself in your hands. Thank you.
Cannot lose our pursuers. We have no choice but to turn and face them.
Too strong. We can't do a thing.
Okay, we have secured our safety. Resume the advance.
Look at that carriage. That must be it. Leave the Emperor and go.
halt, you villains. You'll die before you lay a finger on His Imperial Highness.
We're finished. Forced to return without anything to show for it.
Okay, we have secured our safety. Resume the advance.
Enough of this! Hand the Emperor over! Many others desire the Emperor. Good luck fighting them all.
We have managed to secure Luo Yang. Now, we just need to open a path to Xu Cheng.
Impressive, cousin. You truly are the one that will conquer this land.
We can protect you from here, Your Highness. Please, hide along with your bodyguards. I shall come for you after we have cleared a path. Please, be patient until then.
I am most grateful. I hope you will continue to serve me faithfully.
There are many in addition to Guo Xi and Yuan Shao who would target the Emperor. We need to take him into our custody as soon as possible.
I claim this area as my own.
Hey!
was quite a spectacle.
Truly amazing.
So.
Yeah. Yeah.
I claim this area as my own. Hereby claim this area as my own.
Positions. Capturing that base will weaken the enemy greatly. All units march.
Let's go. Now is the time to attack.
Your might is worthy of a true warrior of the Three Kingdoms.
Yeah.
Now is the time to attack!
Yeah.
Once.
been determined. Capturing that area will deflate their morale.
For me! You are powerless.
Power! Show the enemy no mercy!
So,
Cao Cao have the audacity to take the Emperor under his protection. Does he have no notion of propriety?
You won't make it through here. Not in one piece. Give up your traitorous plans.
Capturing that base will weaken the enemy greatly. All units march! Capturing that base will weaken the enemy greatly. All units march!
So,
was quite a spectacle. Truly amazing.
Let's go. Now is the time to attack.
So.
Been determined. Capturing that area will deflate their morale.
A path has opened up. You have my gratitude.
Please don't mention it, Your Highness. I am simply relieved to see that you are unharmed. Your Imperial Highness, we are trying to erect your palace as quickly as possible. We ask that you please be patient for a little while longer.
Very well. Thank you, Cao Cao. If only I had been stronger, it would not have had to come to this. Although, I must inquire as to why you agreed to help me. I was powerless to stop Dong Zhuo's tyranny.
I did it so that we can bring an end to the chaos. In order to do so, I will require your strength, Your Highness.
My strength?
Currently, the land is overrun with various warlords thirstily grasping for power and influence. If there is no one who can control them and bring about a new world order, the chaos of the land will never end. A combination of intellect and might will be necessary to bring these warlords under control. And the majesty of your position is needed to calm the people.
So you're saying we can work together to return peace to the land? I was unable to take action when Dong Zhuo looked to seize the power of my throne. No, I didn't even try to take action. However, it is clear to me now that there is much to be done. Cao Cao, if I can be of any help to your cause, then I will be honored to do so.
Thank you, Your Highness. I appreciate your generosity more than you know.